leading the service, those joining online now or later. May this church be a space where each one of us feels safe and respected, a part of God's family. God created and cherishes our diversity in age, gender, sexual orientation, body build, health, and history. As we pray, work, sing, lament, and celebrate, we do so as equal members of God's beloved kingdom. May this time be a sacred hour of community with God and with one another. So we have some announcements of what's happening. We pray for Kapuskasing Community Church and Grace United Church in Nipigon. We'll have refreshments and conversation after worship today on Tuesday, July the 26th at 10, coffee and conversation.
That's
the next week. So that was last week, yeah. And there's a big hymn sing on Wednesday, August the 3rd, in the parking lot at St. Stephen's on the Hill. So everybody's welcome. It's at 6:30 p.m. and hopefully people will carpool.
It's going to be a lot of fun, folks.
Yeah. Looking ahead, family faith formation events, August 10th and 24th. At 6, community worship, and it's for all ages together. Trinity Camping, 18 spots, from August the 26th to 28th. Emancipation Day is August the 1st. Yes, there was slavery in Canada. It was abolished on the 1st of August in 1834. No one can own another person in Canada, but there is still work to be done. Look in your email for details about a special online worship on Monday, August the 1st at 11 a.m. I will light the Christ candle. The light of this candle reminds us of the sun's light, illuminating and guiding our daily journeys. It reminds us of the stars, signposts in the night sky. Most of all, it reminds us of the light of Christ, guiding us day and night as we travel through our days.
We gather for worship on land where Indigenous people have lived, worked, raised families, traveled, and followed spiritual practices since time beyond our knowing. This church is located on the traditional territory of the Wanapete First Nation and the Anishinaabe people. We lament the damage that European colonization has had on First Nations, Inuit, and Métis communities. And we acknowledge that many Indigenous people still today live with intergenerational trauma, racism, and inequity. All who live in this area are parties to the Robinson-Huron Treaty, which outlines the shared rights and responsibilities connected to the care and use of this land. As a covenant people, we are called to honor promises. As a church, we have called to a journey of learning, reconciliation, and reparation. As Christ's people, we are called to love our neighbors. May God support and bless our community to live up these calls. The call to worship. Minutes read responsively. Happy Earth Day.
I thought about we celebrated Earth Day back in April.
Mother Earth is our home every day.
Every day is Earth Day.
We are called to be one in community in this our earthly home. We know that God knows and loves us. In the same way, let us love each other, siblings and cousins, not only in word or speech, but in truth and action. Let us join together as one flock to worship the one God. Amen.
Amen. Holy One, heart of creation, you know us and call us into bold service. We come together this day to celebrate your creation. The beautiful streams, lakes, and rivers that surround us and provide us with food and water that are often the center of our communities. We come to hear hard stories of where our still waters have been lost, communities broken. Open our hearts to hear the cries of our family, of partners in Canada and abroad, so that we may be empowered to act in love for one another. For you are our shepherd who leads us toward green pastures. Amen. Our opening hymn is Voices United 242, Let All Things Now Living.
Clouds?
Clouds, yeah. Snow?
Yeah.
Yeah. What about 100 years ago?
Glaciers? No,
glaciers?
Not, maybe.
Yeah.
That's longer.
Yeah. Anyway, water is pretty important, right? We use water every day. Now, at the back of the church, and I'm not really expecting anybody to do this, but okay, thank you. It's not really full, but if this pail were full of water, it would be heavy to carry it all the way up, wouldn't it?
Strong.
Yeah, very strong. Thank you. Yeah. You know, there are many places in the world where people have to carry their water. What would happen if we didn't have any hydro and we had to go to the river and carry all our water that we used in our houses?
Those are children I photographed in Nicaragua.
Oh,
800 people live in a place with no water, and they had to go out with those carts, the children, every day to fetch water for their families.
There are many, many places in the world where people have to carry water to use for their families. And that's a wonderful picture, Faye. Wow. You actually saw them. It's usually the kids and the women that get to do this job, and it happens in many, many, many countries. We are so fortunate here. And it's our responsibility to use our water wisely. So what do you think we should do with this water after we finish with it here?
Water the plants.
Good idea, yeah. We'll water the plants. That way it won't get wasted. Well, thank you. So our next hymn is Like a Healing Stream, and it's in more voices. Water. How many Bible stories do you know that have to do with water? Many of us have heard the story about Moses making water flow from the rock and parting the Red Sea. We may remember stories about Jesus turning water into wine, walking on water, and calming it too. So often, water is a focal point of God's miracles and grace. It figures prominently because it is necessary. Clean water is essential to life, and yet around the world, people suffer for lack of it. The issues are complex. Climate change is altering weather and water patterns, causing shortages and droughts in some areas and floods in others. In some parts of the world, a growing population means rising demand, and there isn't enough water to go around. Water infrastructure problems sometimes mean people can't access water even when it's available. There are racial and gender implications to water, too. Did you know that on an average, women and children in the global south walk nearly 6 kilometers to access water and carry nearly 19 liters of water every day? Through mission and service, you help provide solutions to water issues worldwide. Your generosity supports irrigation projects and provides accessibility to water. Your gifts help construct boreholes, wells, and rain catchment tanks, which in turn address food security and sanitation issues in communities. During crises, your gifts help deliver drinking water where it's needed. Most, in the midst of the global pandemic, your support is helping to construct sanitation stations and share life-saving hygiene communications through flyers and radio programs. Thank you for your generosity. Together, we can build a better world, one water project at a time.
Spirit of life, giver of every perfect gift, we offer our thanks for this life and its gifts. Bless these offerings and those given outside this time of worship. May our contributions here and in every part of our lives, our time, our skills, and our money, work toward a world of justice and peace. We pray that it be so through the ministries of this congregation and through the work we do together through mission and service. In Jesus' name, amen.
Our scripture reading today is from 1 John 3, chapter 3, verses 16 to 24, and it's from the contemporary English version. We know what love is because Jesus gave his life for us. This is why we must give our lives for each other. If we have all we need and see one of our own people in need, we must have pity on that person, or else we cannot say we love God. Children, you should love the others by truly helping them and not merely by talking about it. When we love others, we know we belong to the truth and we feel at ease in the presence of God. But even if we don't feel at ease, God is greater than our feelings and he knows everything. Dear friends, if we feel at ease in the presence of God, we will have the courage to come near him. He will give us whatever we ask because we obey him and do what pleases him. God wants us to have faith in his Son, Jesus Christ, and do love each other. This is also what Jesus taught us to do. If we obey God's commandments, we will stay one in our hearts with him, and he will stay one with us. The Spirit he has given us is proof that we are one with him. The second reading is from John 10, verses 11 to 18, and again in the contemporary English version. I am the good shepherd, and the good shepherd gives us up his life for his sheep. He hired workers. The hired workers are not like the shepherd. They don't own the sheep, and when they see a wolf coming, they run off and leave the sheep. Then the wolf attacks and scatters the flock. Hired workers run away because they don't care about the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep, and they know me. Just as the Father knows me, I know the Father, and I give up my life for my sheep. I have other sheep, and they are not in this sheep pen. I must also bring them together. When they hear my voice, then there will be one flock of sheep and one shepherd. The Father loves me because I gave up my life so I may receive it back again. No one takes my life from me. I give it up willingly. I have the power to give up and the power to receive it back again, just as my Father commanded me to do. And now we will sing from Voices United, "For the Fruit of All Creation." So that's 2:27.
Responsible mining. She says, "We fished for trout and swam in its depths, camped along its shores, picked berries and medicines in the surrounding Caribou Mountains. The entire time, we were sharing our Quechua language and culture with our children." Jacinda's community has has been devastated by the mine waste spill and the ongoing contamination of the water through mine activities. Despite calls from affected communities, church groups, environmental organizations, there has been no accountability or justice for the people, for the animals, for all living near Canal Lake. 7,000 kilometers away, indigenous Lenca communities in Honduras are fighting to stop a mega dam from being built on the sacred Huallcarcri River. Berta Cáceres was their leader. On March the 2nd, 2016, she was shot and killed in her home because of her outspoken voice of dissent. Berta worked tirelessly to protect the river and a way of life at risk. The Huallcarcri River provides Berta's community with food and drinking water. Berta's murder was a clear message to anyone standing up to protect the earth that they also were in danger. The lone witness to her murder said, "Our dream is to build a different world, to generate life amid so much violence and death, but they do not even allow us to do that." Surely, Berta and her community were walking in the most fearsome valleys of death in the days and months before her murder. As an outspoken and committed woman leader, she had been defamed, criticized, and threatened. Yet her struggle for the earth and the sacred water continued. Evil surrounded her, yet she walked proudly in the footsteps of her ancestors, listening and answering the call of the Creator to protect life. Earth Day is a day to remember and care for the earth. It's also a day for action and justice. There's a common chorus in Latin American hymns. God is not in heaven. God is in our brothers and sisters. We know this from 1 John 3, verses 16 through 18. We know love by this, that he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for one another. How does God's love abide in anyone who has the world's goods and sees a brother or sister in need, and yet refuses help? Little children, let us love, not in word or speech only, but in truth and action. Berta laid down her life for her kin. Her death is remembered as the day her seed was sown to be reborn in a million others who will live by her example. She wasn't only fighting for the sacred river to her people, but for all rivers and lakes. "Wake up, humanity," she said, as she received the Goldman Environmental Prize the year before she was killed. "Wake up," she said, "there's no time left." Sister Streams was a movement created by the communities impacted by the Mount Polly mine disaster in BC to remember and honor our waters, to pray for justice and their safekeeping. To celebrate Earth Day is all very well, but we live here on this earth, and our awareness should be a daily thing, not just a thing that happens on one day. We must remember that we have only one planet, and we, as guardians of the Earth, must protect it. As we struggle to respond to the call to be people of faith, caretakers of the Earth and each other, let our discomfort challenge us to use our voice for the voiceless. The trees, the waters, and the mountains. The way Berta and Jacinda did. Closer to home, the Grassy Narrows First Nation in northwestern Ontario. For almost 50 years, the river system a foundational element of the Grassy Narrows culture that the community relies on for food and water, has been contaminated with mercury as a result of industrial pollution. Today, almost 90% of Grassy Narrows community members suffer from symptoms of mercury poisoning. Mercury poisoning has many neurological symptoms, including a ringing of the ears that never ever goes away. Imagine how that would be, and it lasts, it doesn't go away. In the 1960s, the Dryden Chemical Company used mercury in a bleaching process at a paper mill along the English Wabagoon River, just 320 kilometers upstream from Grassy Narrows. When the company was finished with the mercury cells, they would just dump them in the river. Drums of mercury were also buried underground. Jason Kijik, a Grassy Narrows community member, says, "It poisoned our people, and still today, years later, it's leaking into the river system that the river people have lived along. You know, hunting fish every day. It's contaminated my children, and probably their children too, as well, unless something is done." This was said by Jason Kijik during an interview of his community's march through Toronto. This Earth Day, today, tomorrow, every day, as we walk on new grass and the abundance of life and promise blooms all around us, let us work together to protect Mother Earth, our common home. Let us defend her and keep her, honoring the sacrifices that so many have made for us. And let us do our part to live the vision of Jesus for a world of peace and justice. Please join me as we sing a song, "Only One Earth," to end this worship, this sermon.
Thank you.
Creator, Shepherd who laid down his life for love of us, be with us in the light of the violence in our world. Be with the family of Berta Cáceres in Honduras and the people who continue her struggle. Be with the families who relied on the gifts of Lake Canal, which was devastated when the tailings dam burst at Mount Polly Mine in central British Columbia, releasing a 26 billion liters of mine waste into Polly Lake, Hazelton Creek, and Canal Lake, headwaters and spawning grounds of the Fraser River watershed. Be with the people of Grassy Narrows. May their stories and ongoing court proceedings cause our country and our world to rethink our treatment of Indigenous peoples and our industrial practices overseas and at home. Be with those who struggle to protect the forests, the lungs of the earth. Be with the families who suffer from water pollution because of demands of the Western world. Support them as hope for help while they are forced to bathe themselves and their children in waters that give them sores and rashes and is lethal if consumed. Help us discern the best way forward. May we truly understand the blessings we have received from the earth and use it wisely. We pray for miners, for those who put their lives at risk on the job of providing us with resources from the earth. We pray for land, air, and water defenders. For those who question the status quo, may we show compassion and love to both. There are those people in situations that weigh upon our hearts at this time. To name a few, Gary Gray, Howard and Marie Jones, Dorothy Giroux, Len Spry. Anybody that comes to your hearts today, as the Holy Spirit speaks to you, please listen and reach out to those that may be in need of a touch or a word or an encouragement of some kind. Mental illness today and depression is a silent killer, and we all need to do our parts. Let us bring all these names and situations before the Lord, along with others from our hearts. We pray all this in Christ's name. Please join me in the prayers that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The next hymn is Voices United 678, For the Healing of the Nations.
Oh,
world, using Christ as your example.
We go forth to move towards God's reign on earth.
Go into the countryside to root out injustice.
We go forth to promote healing by God's grace.
Go to your families, your friends, your homes, and your community.
We go forth to build right living into all our relationships.
May the love of God surround you, the grace of the Holy Spirit enfold you, and the work of Jesus, our friend and Savior, encompass you this day and always. Amen.